Loki, the god of mischief, was married to Sigyn, and together they had Nari and Vali. Sleipnir, Odin's glorious eight-legged horse, was also part of Loki's offspring, and was conceived in a story that is nothing short of exquisite. Loki also had Angboda as a lover, a beautiful Jotun who lived in Jotunheim. Together, they would give birth to a frightening offspring. One night, Odin, the ruler of Asgard, had a premonition. The god envisioned a major battle between the Asgardians and the forces of darkness, and Loki's offspring would have a major role in that quarrel. His last vision was centered on the jaw of a massive wolf, and then his vision fell into utmost darkness. Odin gathered the gods of Asgard and forced Loki to reveal where his children were living with the giantess. The gods then left for Jotunheim, trying to catch the sons of Loki. After reaching the dwell of the giant Angboda, the gods kidnapped Jotun's children. Loki's offspring were still quite young. One was a snake, another was a wolf cub, and there was a beautiful girl as well, but when she turned, the gods realized that the other side of her body was in every way similar to a rotting corpse. That girl was Hel, and she was certainly a daunting figure. Throughout the journey that would take the gods of Asgard home, Odin noticed that the serpent's size had doubled. What had once been a common snake was now a python. Odin noticed that the serpent kept growing, and he made the decision to throw it into the great sea that surrounded Midgard. The serpent only kept growing over the years, becoming so immense that, one day, its tail already encircled the whole world. This creature made by Loki would receive the name of Jormungandr. All the gods looked suspiciously at Hel in Asgard. Some felt frightened by her. Odin, noticing that the girl preferred the company of the dead than of the living creatures, designated her the ruler of the world of the dead. There she reigned over the souls of those who had an unworthy death and failed to reach Valhalla. In turn, the wolf cub was raised among the gods of Asgard and learned the language of the gods. His name was Fenrir. The god Tyr established a bond with the wolf and they became friends. Like the serpent, his sister, the wolf kept growing. Soon he was bigger than a bull, and, just a short period after, he was already bulkier than any animal that walked the earth. Fenrir inherited some of the worst traits of Loki, his father, including evilness and cruelty. After discussing the subject, the gods decided that something had to be done. A wolf with so much power would be a threat to all the inhabitants of Asgard, and the gods began to plot a way to circumvent that threat.